Hi, I'm Susan McGee. I'm the CEO of Homeward Trust Edmonton, and it's a great pleasure to welcome you to one of the supportive housing sites we are opening in our community, this one in our community of Inglewood.
Yes, welcome. Thanks, Susan. My name is Krista Haff. I'm the Director of Family Services with NCSA, and I'd like to welcome you to our building. Let's go check it out.
Thank you. It's such a welcoming space, and it's really great that when we walk in, we're welcomed by reception. And one of the important things about our supportive housing sites is they all have 24/7 support. I know that this is an important space for you. Why don't you tell us now when we're in just a little bit more about the building?
Sure. Yeah, so this is our common area down here. And so we have space down here where we can gather and mingle. We have a space here where people can come and sit down. Residents come down and play cards and play different kinds of games with our workers. Just a nice place to relax and to build relationship. And another piece of our programming is having an area where people can have a prayer and a smudge. So we have some medicines here that staff and residents can access when they need to just reset and reground themselves. And then we have a kitchen area here where we have the ability to gather with our residents. We can make dinner with the residents or do cooking classes with them as well. And just have a space where we can gather and food brings people together, and especially in the Indigenous community, that's super important to us. So having this amazing kitchen space has been awesome to use. We had a pipe ceremony here in this space in January. And we received a Cree name from our grandfathers and through ceremony. So the name that we were given for the building is tâpwêhtamowin, which in Cree means having belief or having faith in the house. So really creating that sense of community was something that just aligned, and then being given that name was perfect for the site and for what we want to do here.
That's fantastic, and it gives hope to residents, to community, and certainly the staff as well. And so the site has 24/7 staff, different supports. Maybe we can have a look at that space, and you can tell us a little bit more about what they do. So these are all offices that, you know, the different staff, but also InReach supports. So lots of other like smaller spaces, and you're just like working through how this can best support the residents.
Yes, for sure. Yeah, we wanted to have a space and create space for staff that felt comfortable, that felt safe for them, that they could meet the residents and create the healing plans with the residents. So having their own individual spaces was important as a part of our design.
That's fantastic. And at the same time, you know, it is a home, and so all of the residents and from, you know, they have their own mailboxes. We're going to go now up to a couple of units and see just how important having an apartment that's designed really for their long-term success is. So here we are on one of the floors with all of the apartments, and your team's been really busy making them a place, a home for folks.
Yeah, we can check out one of the units here. This is one of our standard bachelor units. It comes with everything that you see in here, along with a care package that every resident will get that has all of the amenities that they can use, including coffee makers, all the utensils that they need for the kitchen, including bedding for the beds, and also towels and stuff like that for the bathrooms. So every resident would receive that care package.
That's great, and it gets them started, and it gets them settled, and then they can make this their home
for sure.
Really customize it. That's fantastic.
Yeah.
And I know that there's other units and different sizes, so maybe let's have a look at another.
Yeah, for sure.
So this is starting to feel a lot more like home. It looks like we've been unpacking and settling in.
Yeah, so this has a one bedroom. This is what it would look like when people start unpacking. These are some of the amenities that they have included that looks like once it's unboxed. They have a table that they can use as a workstation or just to dine.
It's really great that all of these buildings are designed so 50% of their units are barrier-free. So this is one of the units where somebody who is in a wheelchair would be able to really be self-sufficient and be accommodated.
And then we have the one bedroom in here. And as you can see in here, we have the bed all made up for the resident to come in, and every resident gets the bedding that comes with it. So.
So why don't we also look at some of the amenity space? I mean, like all of us in our homes, we want to have a place where we can congregate, maybe some outdoor space. And I know that there's some unique space associated with this particular supportive housing project. So let's go have a look at
yes,
that.
Let's go to the rooftop.
Okay. Oh. And this is a very nice, large, common area that's outdoor. Folks can come out, and I'm sure that you've got some really great plans for this, maybe when the weather warms up a little bit.
Yeah, we have a lot of different ideas of what we want to do out here. So one of the ideas is having garden boxes and having residents tend to the food that we want to grow up here, have them be able to cook it downstairs in the kitchen. And we can also have fun events like having barbecue parties, having gatherings up here, really giving the space that sense of community for the residents. And also another important piece that we are looking to do up here is some ceremony. Ceremony such as pipe ceremonies that we can do with our residents, do some different teachings with them, with our elders, and really just being outside is so important to Indigenous communities and to different teachings that we have. So having this space is gonna be amazing once we're able to use it when the weather warms up.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite things about the building. I mean, I love that so many people will be here and being able to make it their home and yeah. the supports. And the fact that in this community, this is unique to the rest of the supportive housing and that it's got this rooftop. So it's great. And I'm really looking forward to coming back once you've got those gardens underway.
Yeah.
So I understand the mayor's going to be joining us, and he's got some remarks and some comments as well. So we'll shoot down and maybe meet him for a minute.
Yeah. Thanks.
So we're wrapping up our tour of supportive housing in this unit. And I really want to thank everybody for their interest and support of this very, very important work in our community. And thank you, Krista, for hosting us.
Yes, thank you for being here. And when you see a supportive housing site, we hope that you see that we're really working to create change and support change in people moving forward in their lives by providing a safe place for them to live.
Yeah. And this really speaks to the collaboration of Homeward Trust, the Native Counselling of Alberta, City of Edmonton, Province of Alberta, and the federal government working together to make these homes real for people who are struggling. These sites will change people's lives. This is really a sense of community and how community working together. When we all work together, everyone benefits and everyone's lives improve. So this is a great sense of collaboration and it's good for everyone. I want to take a moment to welcome residents to this these very, very nice places where they're going to be able to heal, get better, and get all the necessary support they need.